Yehudit.
Our next speaker is Professor Becca Solomon, and Professor Becca Solomon will talk about novel immunotherapy for Alzheimer's disease. Now, Professor Becca Solomon has already two solutions for Alzheimer's disease which are under license, one with Wyatt in phase 3, and another one with a startup in the U.S.
Good afternoon. I do hope in this 10 minutes to show advantages of the novel immunotherapeutic approach to treat Alzheimer's disease, who have actually prevent some drawbacks of the immunotherapy that we developed 10 years ago. This slide actually shows you the basis of the disease. It's the loss of cognitive function, the loss of identity. And if you have a look in the postmortem brain, because there's no diagnostic test for Alzheimer's disease, these extracellular amyloid plaques, which are built from a beta peptide, and these intracellular aggregates, which are built from tau, and it's more and more evidence that presence of these plaques affect, doesn't work, presence of the plaques affect formation of tangles inside too. Just to have an idea how it's looking a normal brain versus severe Alzheimer's disease affected brains. Okay. As I mentioned, it's no cure or prevention of Alzheimer's disease, and even if we can delete the onset by a few years, it would decrease the prevalence and burden on the public health system. How beta amyloid peptides is generated? The main player in the disease is amyloid precursor protein. I don't know if it works. No one. Anyway. Amyloid precursor protein is the protein. Do you have a better one? Amyloid precursor protein. This protein is cleaved by an enzyme called BACE and give her N-terminal. As a result of this cleavage, after that, gamma secretase is cleaved, and the result you have small oligomers, and finally you have the plaques. It's no consensus who are the more toxic element and who induce the disease, if are the plaques or are the oligomers that Woody mentioned before. So the best way to prevent and to find the treatment and to try to find a method to inhibit formation of amyloid beta peptide. And because of that, BACE became the main attractive target for treatment for Alzheimer's disease. However, short after that, it showed that inhibition of BACE with the enzyme who make the N-terminal of amyloid beta peptide is involved in proteolytic processing of two other proteins with important immunological function. Another drawback is the BACE play a pivotal role in cognitive, emotional, and synaptic function. BACE is required for myelinization of peripheral nerves. All this function is extremely important, so inhibition of the BACE can affect, besides reduction of a beta formation, also a lot of normal process will be inhibited in the brain. And even more than that, was found recently that BACE is not only only enzyme who make beta secretase cleavage. There is other enzyme who actually can make the same role. So from all this reason, we propose a novel approach, which is based by antibody directed against beta secretase cleavage site of APP. And that is shown in continuation, this immunotherapy maintain the benefit but may avoid some adverse effect. We are talking about make antibody against beta cleavage site. This antibody compete with BACE to bind to APP. The antibody are internalized into the cells, and this way they prevent beta amyloid formation. I will show a feasibility study in transgenic mice model of Alzheimer's disease. We treat the mice with the antibody. We try to measure cognitive function of the mice. It's a very accepted one, is object recognition test. The mice are habituated in the box with the two normal objects. They know them. After that, we remove one of them with a new one, and we measure the time who mice stayed and explore the new object. And the index different between the time for the new object versus the old object, called recognition index. This is for mice treated with PBS, the last part, and you have a dose response with antibody. You have very nice reduction, significant increase in recognition index after BBS1 treatment. We have also significant reduction in amyloid burden. This is total area, this is in cortex. The more important thing that the main drawbacks of immunotherapy against the beta is actually neuroinflammation. You can see here that you have, if this, the orange, it's PBS treated, and the blue, light blue and dark blue is treated with different concentration of this antibody. We have very nice reduction of microglia activation, which, as I mentioned, is the main reason of brain inflammation. Another drawback of immunotherapy is microhemorrhage. Actually, the antibody dissolves the plaques, and they dislocate the A-beta from the plaques to blood vessel and lead to CAA, another amyloid on the blood vessel, who actually disrupt and make this kind of hemorrhage. Well, you can see this is the level of microhemorrhage in normal mice. Treatment with high dose reduces extremely nice possibility of microhemorrhage. So if you try to summarize, the achievement of this new approach show improved cognitive function, reduce amyloid load, reduce microglia activation, and reduce brain hemorrhage. This is the first attempt to inhibit beta sarcoglycan activity by blocking the cleavage site of APP. Our approach overcome some of the limitations presented by BACE inhibitor regarding non-specific inhibition of BACE activity, and also other proteins are able to cleave APP at the beta site. Moreover, some of the drawbacks induced by immunotherapy against A-beta, which actually now running in clinical trials, like hemorrhage and brain inflammation, are prevented by this antibody against the beta cleavage site. This is my group. I want to thank you, everyone, and I want to thank you for your attention.